So this was in 49. Late October, I finally got my permit to come to Canada from the Canadian Embassy. And I tell you, I was a real happy young man. And a couple days later, they got me on a train and we went to Hamburg. I got on this boat, the Samaria, and we came in the hold of the boat as DPs. And I arrived in Quebec City, I think it was October the 29th of 1949. And when I saw, when the boat entered the Gulf of St. Lawrence and I saw Quebec City, I saw the immense size of this country. And finally, we got off the boat, and I was really happy. It was a new start for me, you know, it was a new life. And I was given a cup of coffee and a sandwich, and they put us on a train, and I had 50 cents in my pocket. I couldn't buy any other food on the train because I had no money. And I guess a couple of days later, I arrived in Toronto at the Union Station, and one of my friends picked me up, and he took me to a place where I was going to live. It was on Huron Street with a family, Mr. and Mrs. Cass, where three of us survivors, you know, three of us youngsters, we lived there with her. And we became a ward of the Jewish Family and Child Service here in Toronto. And they helped us out. They paid for our room and board until we could find a job. And since it was winter, they sent us to, I guess, to Tip Top Tailors, and they made a coat for us. We were given a winter coat and a suit. And soon enough, soon after I found a job, or they found a job, they sent me to a job, and I was working at first in a luggage factory on Spadina here. And I was working there, I think they were paying me 20 cents an hour. And finally I got another job. It was a place where they were making wedding albums. And there was a lady, her name was Rose, and finally she asked me she saw every day I was bringing my sandwiches, and it was the same sandwich, a Kaiser bun with cottage cheese and an egg, and she finally said, well, I'll exchange your lunch, and she eventually asked me to come up to her house, and that was really great, because, you know, I was sort of made contact with a family, and that's where I met my future wife. Her daughter became my wife eventually. And, you know, she helped me a great deal. My mother-in-law, she's passed away now. And so I became a Canadian, and I went through, I finally found myself a career and built a manufacturing company. We have a family business. And we have twin sons, and we have two granddaughters, and I'm a really happy person.